Today's session we have to discuss the next part of the steroid, that is corticosteroids. It's the unit 4 topic of essentials of medicinal chemistry 2 as per your PCI syllabus, corticosteroids. First of all, we have to discuss the indirect part related to the corticosteroids. Corticosteroid itself indicate that it is one of the class of steroidal hormones. That includes hormone synthesized. These steroids, steroids are classified on the basis of their synthesis, they are categorized. Here, corticosteroids, they are categorized. These hormones are synthesized in the adrenal cortex of the vertebrates and the synthetic analogs of these hormones. Means generally these hormones are synthesized in the adrenal cortex. That's why the name is given as a corticosteroids. Corto means cortex. The steroids from the cortex. It's called as corticosteroids. They have large number of physiological processes such as stress responses, immune response, regulation of inflammations, carbohydrate metabolisms, protein catabolisms, blood electrolyte levels, and their behaviors. They are giving the actions of these corticosteroids at different phases, like stress management, stress response in our body, immune system, immune response. They regulate the inflammations produced in our body, carbohydrate metabolisms, protein catabolisms, and blood electrolyte levels. And the corticosteroids, some examples, common examples, naturally occurring corticosteroids, hormones. The examples are corticosteroids, cortisones, and aldosterones. These corticosteroids having the carbon atom 21. C21 steroid moiety, nothing but is a corticosteroids. If in examination ask, C21 containing steroidal moiety, then your answer is go with the corticosteroids or give the name corticosterones or cortisones. These are the natural occurring hormones of corticosteroid category. This next session, next slide, in this slides, the classification of corticosteroids. They are generally classified into two segments. First is glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. In glucocorticoids, they control the carbohydrate, fat, and protein metabolisms. Name itself indicates glucocorticoid. It is related with the controlling of carbohydrate, fat, protein metabolism. They show anti-inflammatory actions by inhibiting phospholipid release and reducing the eosinophil actions and some other mechanism by this glucocorticoid. Whereas mineralocorticoids, they regulate the electrolyte and water balance by stimulating sodium retention in the kidney. These are the two types of the corticosteroids, glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids, along with their actions or metabolism where they exert their actions. As per syllabus is concerned, the following corticosteroids are mentioned in your syllabus, that is cortisones, hydrocortisones, prednisolones, betamethasones, and dexamethasones. Now we have to move with the discussion one by one with this corticosteroid examples. Now we have to move with the first example of corticosteroid moiety, that is cortisones. Cortisones is a naturally occurring glucocorticoids. It is used in replacement therapy of the adrenal insufficiency. In that conditions, these cortisones are given to the particular patients. It also used as a anti-inflammatory activity and also inactive compounds, and it convert in liver to hydrocortisones. Means these cortisones, when metabolites in liver, they convert into its active form, that is hydrocortisones. This is the structure of cortisones, the steroidal moiety, phenanthrene, cyclopentane. This is a C18 carbon atom, C19 methyl group carbon atom, C20 and C21. Means in this steroids, there are carbon atom present in the structure is C21. So all the moiety of corticosteroid is C21 moiety and their substitutions. This is structures. This is a chemical name for cortisones. It contains keto groups. This ON in cortisones, this TI indicating tri, this ON containing C double bond O. This is three C double bond O present in the structures. One is at third positions. This is at 11 positions and C20 position. The keto group is present. That's why the 3, 11, 20 triols and the hydroxy groups present at C17 alpha positions and C21 positions. The hydroxy group is present. So the name of this cortisone is 17 alpha 21 dihydroxy prigine 4EN. It's a whole moiety. 21 carbon containing moiety is prigine 4ENE. ENE for this double bonds. And 3, 11, 20 triols. This is IUPAC name for this cortisones. Their uses for these cortisones, this is used in the replacement therapy for adrenal insufficiency and act as an anti-inflammatory agents. This cortisone also act as an anti-inflammatory agents. This is also used in the rheumatoid arthritis like conditions. These drugs are used, and apart from this, these cortisones are used in allergic conditions as well as chronic lymphatic leukemia like conditions. These cortisones are used. This is related with the cortisones. Now, the active form of the cortisone after metabolism, that is hydrocortisones. This hydrocortisone is a synthetic or semi-synthetic analog of the naturally occurring hydrocortisones hormones. It is formed from the adrenal gland and exhibit primary glucocorticoids and minor mineralocorticoid effect. This is structure of hydroxycortisones. In cortisones and hydroxycortisones, hydrocortisones, there is addition of this hydroxy group in cortisones. That's why their name is 11 beta 17 alpha 21 trihydroxy bridge 4EN 3,20 diodes. What is the difference between cortisone and hydrocortisones? This hydroxy group of keto group of cortisone is replaced with hydroxy groups at 11 position. That moiety is called as hydro moiety, means addition of hydrogen atom in cortisones, where at C11 positions the hydrogen is added. That's why the name is hydrocortisones. The IUPAC name is 11 beta 17 alpha 21 trihydroxy prigine 4EN 320 diones. This 20 and third position dione is present. The uses of this hydrocortisones, this is a synthetic counterpart, is used either as an injectable or topical for treating inflammations, allergic like conditions, arthritis, lupus, severe psoriasis, ulcerative colitis, collagen disease, asthma, adrenocortical deficiency, shock, and neoplastic conditions. These hydrocortisones are used. And this drug also used in the same as like cortisone, adrenal insufficiency these hydrocortisones are given. Also, this drug is used in the treatment of Addison's disease. Third corticosteroid, that is prednisolone, as per your syllabus concern. Everyone might be heard this name, prednisolone. This is a steroidal anti-inflammatory agent. This prednisolone is a glucocorticoid having general property like corticosteroids, that is C21 carbon atom present in the steroids. This drug, that is prednisolone, it is a choice of drug in condition with systemic corticoid. Systemic therapy, this drug is used, prednisolone. Except adrenal deficiency state, this drug not used. This is structure for prednisolone, steroidal moiety. The difference is only with, if you compare with the cortisones, here double bond is present. And hydroxy group is present as compared to cortisone. Here double bond is present in cortisone. Here in prednisolone, hydroxy group is present. Carbon-carbon double bond at 1 and 2 positions in cortisones. So their name is 11 beta 17 21 trihydroxy trigona 1,4 dienes 1 and 4 position diene is present, 320 dienes. If you compare with the hydrocortisones, there is addition of double bond in prednisolones as compared to hydrocortisones and this methyl group. The uses of prednisolone, this drug is used as a primary or secondary adrenocorticoid insufficiency like conditions, these drugs are used. This drug also used in the psoriatic arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis like conditions, spondylitis, acute gouty arthritis and epicondylitis, these drugs are used. These drugs, earlier I told that this drug is a steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. That's why it is used in the arthritic conditions. It is also given in systemic lupus erythematosus, also used in the acute rheumatic carditis. This drug also used in the for the treatment of leukemia, lymphoma, thrombocytopenia, purpura, autoimmune, hemolytic, ammonia, like conditions, these drugs are used. This drug also used in the celiac disease, insulin resistance conditions, ulcerative colitis, and liver disorders. These drugs are used. After prednisolone, another drug is betamethasone. Betamethasone is a glucocorticoid. It is administered orally, parenterally, by local injections. By inhalation process also, these drugs are used. Some asthmatic patients, generally these drugs are given in asthma-like conditions. Or topically, these drugs are given. This is structure of betamethasone. Same like prednisolone, but difference, here fluorine is present. And C16 positions, the methyl group is present. So, this is a structural difference as compared to the prednisolone. Addition of 9 alpha fluoro and 16 beta methyl positions. But the rest are similar to the prednisolone. So, the name of this betamethasone is 16 beta methyl 1,4 pregadienes, 9 alpha fluoro, 11 beta, 17 alpha, 21 triol, 3, 20 diones, that is keto group. present in the structure of beta-metazoans. The uses of these beta-metazoans, for topical use, they are available in the form of creams. Foams, lotions, and ointment for relieving the inflammatory actions. And prothetic manifestation of corticosteroids responsive dermatoses like conditions, these drugs, beta-metazoans are used. In systematically, the beta-metazoans used in endocrine disorder, rheumatoid disorder, collagen disease, dermatological disease, allergic states, ophthalmic diseases, respiratory diseases like asthma, these drugs are used, hematological disorders, neoplastic diseases, osteomyelitis states, GI diseases, tuberculosis like conditions, trichinosis, death conditions, the beta-metazoans are used. Now, next part of the corticosteroid, next example is dexamethasone. In these structures, there is a only difference of prednisolones. There is addition of 9-alpha-fluoro, 16-alpha-methyl groups in prednisolone. Means this addition of fluoride and methyl group in prednisolones are added. And that compound is called as dexamethasones. Baki rest of the structure is same like prednisolone, just addition of fluorine and methyl groups. Which type of? Dotted line indicating alpha and solid line indicating, dark solid line indicating beta. So the name is 9-alpha fluoro 16-alpha methyl prednisolone, or you can return 16-alpha methyl 9-alpha fluoro 1-dehydracortisol. The IPC name for this, dexamethasone. Dexamethasone is a potent synthetic glucocorticoid, and these drugs are used as an anti-inflammatory and immunosuppressant like conditions. Dexamethasones are used. These drugs also used in the endocrine disorders, same like beta-metazoans, rheumatic disorders, collagen diseases, dermatological diseases, allergic like conditions, ophthalmic disease, GI disease, respiratory disease, neoplastic diseases, these drugs are used. These drugs also used for the treating of steroid responsive inflammatory conditions. Means sometimes the steroids are given for the controlling the inflammation like conditions, these dexamethasones are given to particular patients. These drugs also used in the bulbar congestiva like conditions, pyorrhea, anterior segment of the globe. These drugs are used. This dexamethasone also used in the steroid responsive inflammatory situation of external auditory meatus like conditions. This drug also used in the bronchial asthma like conditions, and it is also used in allergic and inflammatory nasal conditions. These dexamethasones are used. These are the all corticosteroids. Some are natural occurring corticosteroids, some are synthetic corticosteroids.